Welcome back friends, I am developing a billing system real-time project. It will be very useful for a job seeker who wanted to gain real-time experience in Spring Boot. Also, I am developing this application for small retailers. The source code is absolutely free for student and job seeker. Source code of billing system is absolutely free for student and a job seeker. There are many billing system related videos I have already posted. If you want to view those videos, go to pinepad.in. You can see here one link called billing system videos. Click that link. You will be getting all billing system related videos from the beginning to updated one. If you need latest code of billing system, click downloads. You will be navigating to this page. Click download button. You will be getting latest source code of billing system. Also, I have posted billing system related articles. Whatever video I have posted related to billing system, for those videos I have created articles in this site. If you want to read those articles, click billing system articles. It will return all the articles. These articles about setting up IntelliJ, setting up a billing system. So all billing system related articles available here. Okay. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Please subscribe the channel and share this channel to your friend circle who wanted to gain real-time product experience in Spring Boot. All billing system necessary information I have given in the video description. Please check it out. Let's go into the video now. Welcome back friends. In this video, we will going to talk about purchase order. What is the use of purchase order? What is the role of purchase order in our billing system? That we need to understand. Let's say I want to sell some product. Let's say I want to sell some t-shirts. In order to sell a t-shirt, I need to buy the t-shirt from the manufacturer. From the manufacturer or wholesale retailer. I need to buy those t-shirts from the manufacturer or wholesale retailer. Whenever you buy some product from the manufacturer or wholesale retailer, that information we need to maintain in the purchase order table. The wholesale retailer manufacturer is nothing but a vendor. Okay, that vendor information we are maintaining in the vendor table. That vendor ID mapped with the purchase order table. Okay, then this purchase order table mapped with the tax table, linked with the tax table. When you look at here, there is a tax ID, right? The tax ID. This tax ID value coming from tax table. That ID having a one tax percentage. That tax percentage applied to the product which we maintaining in the purchase order. Okay, so through this tax table, we come to know that what is the tax percentage of the particular product in the purchase order table. Then category table. Through this category table, we come to know that what is the category of particular product we are bought from manufacturer. Okay, this three table linked with the purchase order. Now we'll going to check other columns. ID is a primary key, is underscore deleted is a flag. Using that flag, we can find out the particular record is deleted or not. Purchase order code is a unique code I will going to generate. Whenever I create a new purchase order, the one new code will generate and store it to this column. Then the product name, name of the product, and the product description. Unit price. This price is a particular per product price. For example, let's say I'm buying a 10 products. 10 t-shirts from the manufacturer. For each product have some price, right? That is called as a unit price. Let's say one product price is 100 rupees means that 100 rupees available in the unit price. Then quantity. If I buy 10 products, 10 t-shirts, then 10 will be available in the quantity. Then total amount. Total amount nothing but quantity is a 10. Unit price is a 100. 100 into 10, 1000. 1000 will be available in the total amount. Total amount. Then tax ID. This tax ID mapped with the particular tax percentage. Let me explain clearly. We saw unit price, quantity, total amount. Let's say if you have a tax percentage, it's a 5%. Now we need to calculate that 5% with the total amount of the value. That if we calculate with 5%, we will be getting 50 rupees as a tax. Then grand total is 1050. This column available here. Okay, tax amount will be displayed here. This is a total tax amount. Let's say if you buy a 10 t-shirt, for 10 t-shirt, the total tax amount available here. Grand total. Grand total is a total amount of the product, then tax amount of the product. Sum of total amount of the product and the tax amount of the product is a grand total. Okay. This is the total amount of the product. This is the tax amount of the product. This tax amount is a total amount. That is, for 10 quantity, tax amount is a 50. For total amount, tax amount total is a grand total. That is a 1050. Through in this way, I am storing the data in the purchase order table. I have already implemented the code. It's working fine. The latest code is available in the PinePad.in. Go to PinePad.in site. Click download link. Get the latest code. Now we're going to walk through the code. Okay. In the repository package, there is a purchase order repository. Through this repository class, I can do crude operation. That is add, update, read, and delete. Those two operations I can do through this product repository. This product repository I auto wide in product service class. In the product service class, I have one method called save method. In the save method, I have a code implementation of storing a purchase order, storing and updating a purchase order. Okay. This purchase order info coming from the controller class. I have created one controller class called purchase order controller. This controller class having a method called add method. This add method having a request body is a purchase order info. Purchase order info is a request body. Whenever client sends the information, that information come in the form of purchase order info. That object I am passing a save method, which is coming from purchase order service. Using my MapStruct framework, I am using a MapStruct framework to convert purchase order info to an entity object. Using that MapStruct framework, I am converting purchase order info to my purchase order entity object. Then, if you want to store purchase order, we need to pass category, we need to pass vendor, we need to pass tax. In the JSON request, when I look at the JSON request, here we have in the JSON request, you can see vendor ID, tax ID, and a category ID. Okay. Using that ID, I am taking category object, I am taking vendor object, I am taking tax object. Okay, then that object I am setting into my purchase order entity object. If the ID is null, that is, this block always come to whenever you create a new purchase order. This block will come to whenever you create a new purchase order, that time this block will execute. Okay, that meaning we are creating a new purchase order. Whenever we create a new purchase order, I want to generate one unique code, unique purchase order code. That code I am generating through this method. This will return a new purchase order code. Then that code I am setting into my purchase order entity object. This particular coding part is calculating a tax information. I have written a separate class for tax calculation. I have done separate class for tax calculation. There is a tax calculation. It's a component class. Okay. This class having a method called calculate method, calculate tax method. This method doing the tax calculation for given product. Okay. Friends, I cannot explain line by line code. Just I can say this method will do this, this method will do this. Okay. Please go through the code. Please read the code. Try to understand. If you're not able to understand, just comment me. Definitely, I'll go into reply. Okay. This calculate tax method accept one parameter called tax calculation input. When you look at tax calculation import, it has a three attribute: unit price, tax percentage, and a quantity. Unit price, tax percentage, then quantity. Go back to tax calculation. Once you pass that information in the form of tax calculation input, I am taking that properties in this method, and using that property, I am calculating the tax amount of the particular product. Then that tax information I am setting into tax calculation response, setting it to tax calculation response. I am returning that response object. I am returning that response object here. Okay. Once you get the response object, from the response object, I am taking total amount, grant total amount, tax amount. Okay. This information, these values I am taking from tax calculation response. That value I am setting into purchase order. When you look at tax calculation response, it has a three attribute: total amount, tax amount, grant total. Once I calculate the tax data, that tax data I am setting into tax calculation response. See, set tax amount, set total amount, set grant total. Okay. Then this response object I am returning back here. From this response object, I am taking total amount, grant total, tax amount. Those value I am setting into my purchase order entity object. Once all data populated inside a purchase order, I am passing that object to save method, which is coming from purchase order repository. It will save the data into database. Okay. Once it saves the database, it will return a new purchase order entity object that assigning to here. Now I want to convert this purchase order entity object to purchase order info. Okay, this info object will return in a client side. So I am wrapping this information, wrapping this product into my response object. That response object returning back to my controller. My controller. Now this response object contain purchase order info. That object display in client side as a success response. Okay. The same thing for update. This is for add. For adding, I have a one endpoint. For updating, I have an endpoint. It's a put mapping. For updating, I have another endpoint method. It's a put mapping. For fetch all purchase order, I have another endpoint called purchase. It returns all the purchase order data. This endpoint for returning particular purchase order by passing ID, primary key. Okay. There are four methods implemented in the purchase order controller. This is the about purchase order code implementation. Now you're going to see the demo. Okay. If you want to populate a purchase order, as of now there is no data, right? If you want to populate purchase order, we need to populate three dependent table. One is vendor table. Another one is tax table, another one is category table. These three table IDs mapped in the purchase order table. Okay, whenever you buy a purchase order, we need to populate the vendor ID, that is which vendor you are buying the product. That vendor ID should map here. Okay, then if you buy any product from the vendor, that product is having some tax amount, right? That tax information we are taking from tax table. So tax ID is mapped in purchase order. Then category, we need to tell what is the category of a particular product you are buying from the vendor. Okay, so we need to map the category ID. We need these three data. If you want to populate purchase order, we need to populate these three data in our database. The vendor table is having, a data, tax table also having a data, category table also having a data. Okay. For these three data, we have a these three data primary key is a one only. See, vendor is a one, tax is a one, category is also one. For this, we need to generate a JSON request to save purchase order. I have already designed a JSON request for purchase order. Let me open Postman. I will show you that JSON request. Yeah, this is the JSON request. I'm copying that and I want to store it here. Okay, whenever you take a latest code, you can get the JSON request for purchase order from here. Okay, purchase order request JSON. In the JSON request, we need to pass product name, product description, then quantity of the product, what is the unit price for the product, then which vendor ID, which vendor you are buying this product, that vendor ID we need to pass, then what is the tax percentage, that tax ID we need to pass, then category, what is the category of this product, that category ID we need to pass. This is the JSON request. Okay, this JSON request I'm going to use here. See here, we don't have any data now. Now I'm going to send a request. Sorry, server is not started. I need to start the server. Okay. Server is started now. Now I'm going to send a request. It's giving forbidden error. Okay, it's giving forbidden error. The reason is, as of now, this endpoint is and I cannot access because the token is invalid. The token is already expired, I think. Okay. If token is expired, we need to generate a new token. We need to add the token here. In our billing system, we cannot access any endpoint directly. Without authorization, we cannot access. We need to generate the token, JWT token. We need to pass the token here. Okay. We need to remember that. You need to remember that. Okay. Don't forget. This is the authenticate endpoint. Using this endpoint, we can generate the JWT token. What is the username and the password? My username is suresh@bmp.com. The password is 123. To make sure that you are passing correct username and the password. To check that, go to user. See here, I have suresh@bmp.com. Password is 123. Okay. I am passing the same here. Once you send a request, it will generate JWT token. It's generated now. Copy that token. Go to purchase endpoint. In the header section, authorization part, just replace with the existing one. If you don't have anything, just type bearer, one space, bearer, one space, then paste the generated JSON token, okay, a JWT token. Now I'll go to send a request. See, now it's success. It's created. See, product name is t-shirt. These are t-shirt for men. Quantity is 10. Unit price is 100. Let's check the database. See, t-shirt, this t-shirt for men. Unit price 100, quantity is 10. Tax ID for tax ID 1. What is the tax ID 1? See, tax ID 1, there is a tax percent is a 5%. Okay, so it's calculating the 5%. This is a 5% tax ID. When you look at the tax table, it says 5%, right? So we need to use 5% for this product. If you calculate using 5%, it will return a 50 rupees, the tax amount. Then total amount, tax amount is 1050 is a grand total. The grand total is tax amount plus total amount. It's a 1050. Then vendor ID is a 1, category ID is a 1. See, category ID also 1 year. So we have successfully populated the one purchase order. If you want to view the purchase order, change here to get. Then slash one, it will return that purchase order. Slash one, what is that? So the purchase order ID is a 3, that's the reason it's giving the null. Okay, so we need to pass here 3. So it's giving the third record. information. Purchase order ID is the third record. That information I'm able to get here. If you want to view all the purchase order, just remove that ID, keep it up to purchase, then send. Again, it will return the same because we have only one record. I have already committed this code in the repository. You can download the code from pinepad.in. You can download the code from pinepad.in. Click download. It will give you the latest source code of billing system. Please play around it. Let me know if you have doubt. Okay. Definitely, I am here to help you. In order to set up a billing system in the local machine, I have given all information in the YouTube video description. Not only in this video, every video I have given all information how to set up a billing system. After setting up the billing system, how to create the first user, all the related video link I have given in the YouTube video description. Please read carefully. Okay. In the next video, I will going to talk about product table, how to populate the product. I will going to explore. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.